The WHO just issued a report on health, and it's not pretty. Now, I'm not talking about the rock band. I'm talking about the World Health Organization, and they just issued a statement on air pollution and how it affects your health, and it was pretty frightening, let me tell you. Now, I'm someone who's really aware of air pollution because, for some reason, I've ended up living in some of the worst polluted areas of the world, one of them Los Angeles, which is just horrible. And I've lived in some of the most pristine and clear. I've lived in Hawaii, which I just love the air there. It's so moist and vibrant. But the reality is when I lived in LA, I remember how there was a report that would come out every couple of years that showed that children at the age of 5, when they were tested in the Los Angeles area, already had measurable limits of lung damage from the air pollution. 5 years old, lung damage. You could measure it, right? It's from the particles in the air. It's all the soot, the type of things that come from automobiles, diesels, trucks, buses. In fact, I was still dreaming of being a triathlete when I lived in Los Angeles, even though I had had an accident and had been dealing with my chronic fatigue. And every time that I would go out and ride my bus, I'd come home and I'd have a gray film across my teeth from all the soot that was in the air from the vehicles. In fact, my herb program at that time actually used an herb called schizandra combined with a formula called platycotton and fritillaria, what herbal is called plat and frit because it's much easier. And that is a formula that was usually used in cases of bronchitis or a chest cold where you had to cough up this heat and infection and get it out of your lungs. Well, it actually worked really well for bicycling around Los Angeles because schizandra is one of the most potent lung detoxing herbs you could ever take, and it builds lung chi. You can take deeper breaths, you have more lung power, and that's always important with somebody that's cycling. But the platycotton and fritillaria moistened my lungs and it enabled me to cough up excessive grime or things that I might have taken into my system just because of my environment. And so that has become one of my all-time great formulas. You know, I was born with a lung weakness. This is something else. You always have to look at what's your weakness in life. Well, I had walking pneumonia when I was 9 months old. And so my lungs are weak and they have a tendency when I get an infection to go straight into my lungs. Well, after years of taking that formula and always having some in the house, I rarely ever have an issue with that anymore because I've corrected my weakness or imbalance. And I continue to take schizandra almost every single day. Why? Because it's in Tian Chi. It's the number one herb. It's the largest herb in Tian Chi. And in fact, it's in a therapeutic dose. The dose that's in Tian Chi was actually a dose used in China in a study on hepatitis, you know, treating hepatitis with just schizandra, the herb, and it was quite successful. So that gives you an idea how powerful of a lung detoxing herb it is and a liver detoxing herb. But the main gist of this, though, is telling you that most people have to do something to protect themselves. Just like with this report from WHO, they show that 25% of all deaths from heart disease and stroke are related to air pollution. Something like 43% of all chronic obstructive pulmonary disease is related to air pollution. 29% of lung cancer is air pollution. Now, can you imagine if you're also a smoker and you're experiencing these conditions? What if you lived in Mexico City? Mexico City, they say the air is so bad that it's similar to smoking 3 packs of cigarettes a day. Well, what if you also smoke 2 packs of cigarettes a day? Can you imagine the state of health that your body's going through? Can you imagine how much work it has to do to just offset walking around and breathing? There was a test done recently. A research group out of Montana was in Mexico doing autopsies and found an 11-month-old baby that had the two main markers for Alzheimer's disease. And it was all related to the pollution, the air pollution. Now, I'm not telling you all this to scare you. I'm just telling you that Life has a lot of surprises. It has a lot of things out there that are damaging to your health. You know, companies that make most products, and you know, it doesn't matter what type of manufacturing process it is, they're not in the business of making healthy things for you. You have to find those things out yourself. They're in the business of making money. They don't think of the long-term consequences of it. It's our job to protect ourselves and to put ourselves in a position where we thrive and feel the most alive every single day. And you do that, in my opinion, by the way you live, the way you love, and the type of nutrients you take and the herbs that you take. And for me, herbs is a huge part of my life. And I just can't imagine being without the things I get out of my herbal program, which again is feeling the ability to thrive and to be alive and to be open and growing and always moving forward.